All right, what is going on? Big day. We are here with the Akai MPC 2000 Classic, as it's affectionately called. The first of sort of the revival of the MPC in the 1990s. Now, today is a great day because I am introducing a brand new manual called The Anatomy of the Akai MPC Series Standalone Samplers. Now, this manual is designed to get you completely up to speed on how standalone MPCs work, right? And this is a manual for sort of the younger generation coming up that has never really touched an MPC before, that's been standalone, just have no idea of what an MPC is and how it works. This is the manual for those of you who have seen a celebrity use an MPC and been like, I want one of those, I'm gonna get one. There's been so many times where viewers have reached out to me and wanted to buy an MPC, and I've warned against it just because of my concern that it may be a little bit too foreign for them coming from a software environment or any environment or even a first-time aspiring beatmaker to get into. This manual covers all of that. It essentially covers the common traits that exist between all standalone MPCs. That goes from the MPC60 all the way up to the MPC5000. All MPCs in that variety have common things that they all share and operate on those premises. And once you have a firm grasp on how MPCs work, you'll be comfortable with any MPC that you get on that is a standalone model. The information is in the description box below. It's available right now, the anatomy of the Akai series samplers. If you've ever wanted to know what makes MPC so special, but you're apprehensive about the learning curve, this manual is for you. All right, now let's get to it. To exemplify what makes the MPC so special, we're just going to go over some things that you may almost take for granted. Those of us who are seasoned MPC users or just are familiar with MPCs, we're going to go over the things that make MPCs what they are. So the first thing is responsiveness. These machines are so responsive that you can become spoiled by them just by nature of using them all the time. I mean, what you press, that's what you get right away. And if you're coming from a DAW world, you'll be kind of shocked at how responsive MPCs are. They just do what you want right away without hesitation. It's really instantaneous and it's really a joy to use. Even me, coming from an Ensoniq background, the MPCs are just incredibly right there with you all the time. They don't drag behind you. They're right there to do what you want them to do right away. The second thing I would say is the timing. Timing is key. I mean, that's what makes the MPC what it is. Making any type of beat on the MPC is actually really fun to do. It's difficult to get frustrated with an MPC just because it has a way of making whatever you play sound good. Most sequencers, you have to try a couple times to get something kind of the way you want it. With the MPC, it just puts the beats where you kind of always thought it should go. I mean, it's so bad that you'll play a rhythm and you'll know you played it kind of off. But when you play it back in the MPC, it sounds better than what you thought because of the resolution of the MPC and the incredible timing that it has. When I'm speaking of timing, I'm speaking of the quantize options here. They just make everything sound cool. So I'm going to demonstrate that right now by playing a beat, and I'm just going to play it any kind of way, and we'll see how the MPC takes what I played and interprets it into something that's better than what you actually see me playing versus what you hear coming out of the MPC. Okay, you see, I played as off as I could, and even as hard as I tried, the MPC just kind of took it and put it right dead on a 16th note grid, nicely, right? Which is what it's supposed to do, but just bear in mind, most sequencers will not do it that effortlessly. It will sort of put things maybe a note before, a note after, and it won't really get it right. The MPC just has a way of getting it right away, no matter how hard you mess up. So that's with poor playing. If you are a decent player, or even somebody that plays something more intentful than I did just now, it will be all gravy. It's a really classic drummer scene for a reason. Once again, this is something that we all take for granted, but try and think of a sequencer that has been more impactful and more fun to use and more generally powerful than an MPC throughout history, right? This has such a large place in sequencer history as far as electronic music goes that you don't even think about it anymore. You just think, oh yeah, MPC, it's an MPC, whatever. But when you try to think of an alternative that could even stand in the same room as an MPC, it becomes very, very difficult. When you combine the sequencer, the feel, the timing, the responsiveness, all in one package, not to mention that its ability to pitch samples, although it's limited, it is a great asset. So what you can also do is you can pitch samples. So I just have a sound there, and you can put it onto 16th notes where you're able to take a simple sample and pitch it across these 16 pads. So even though this is a drum machine, the MPC borrows on the legacy structure of the SP1200 and 12, where you can take one sample and spread it across the keys for melodic playing. So we'll just do that now with this sound. Press 16 keys, designate the note. Right, you're able to pitch the sample to give you some sort of melodic advantage. And bear in mind, this is a drum machine, so this style of playing a sample chromatically traditionally really has no place in a drum machine, but it does. And this has birthed the various uses that we've heard all over classic hip-hop records as a method of playing samples back. And this is a trait, again, that you see on all MPCs. And at the same time, it's something that you think nothing about just because the MPC has such a strong foothold in drum machine culture. But it's definitely something that needs to be spoken about. And again, for those of you who are first seeing an MPC because you may have just been introduced to it or are getting into this beat-making culture, understand that this is a classic piece of history. Anyway, that is all I wanted to share with you guys today. Info in the box below for the anatomy of the MPC series standalone samplers. I will catch you on the next one. In the meantime, please do take care of yourself. Peace.